They told us to roll up our sleeve on our sleeve on the left arm, and they gave us the tattoo.
Suddenly, we had no names. We were not Robert Wiedemann. I was A5714 from then on. I never realized how, you know, how quickly they can kill me. So I entertained the people. I was known as Didi, the singer dancer.
Buchenwald, it was a tremendous camp. The big camp and then the little camp.
I say, if we do get liberated, I'm going to go back and do show business, but Robert Wiedemann is not a good name. And I said to the two guys, I say, Robert Clary, and they said, yeah, that's a great name. And that's how I became Robert Clary in Buchenwald.
It's April 11th, 1945. American Army liberated the camp.
In France, I was a band singer. There's a man called Harry Bluestone. And he said to me, I want to record you for America. 6 months later, he calls me back. He said, you're a big hit in America. I want you to come over.
We did the first musical cinemascope that came out, and it was a tremendous hit all over the world.
I was lucky after that.
In 65, I did Hogan's Heroes, a tremendous hit all over the world. My life, I did a lot of movies, a lot of nightclubs, a lot of Broadway shows. People remember me from the 6 years on Hogan's Heroes.
And then from Days of Our Lives, Young and the Restless, and The Bold and the Beautiful. I loved the great composers and lyricists.
Come on in here, Alexander's Ragtime Band.
1980, I joined the Simon Wiesenthal Center when I realized that I cannot stay silent about my experiences. And I must tell you, it is the most gratifying thing I've done in my entire life.